Principal Zan expressed concern about their arrival in the territory of the Heavenly Soul Empire and whether they would receive a warm welcome. Principal Yan playfully called Principal Xian by the name Lin Er, emphasizing the importance of returning safely to Shrek Academy and teasing Principal Xian's love for battles. Principal Xian became annoyed and reminded Principal Yan of her proper title. Principal Yan, however, respectfully referred to him as Valkyrie Duluo. She acknowledged his title and reminisced about the memorable moments associated with it. Principal Xian asserted his authority, implying that only he had the right to take certain actions. Nevertheless, Principal Yan stressed the significance of family and urged Principal Xian not to hold grudges. Despite this, Principal Xian made it clear that he would not engage further with Principal Yan. Yu Hao watched their interaction with a puzzled expression on his face. As the sky suddenly grew dark, Principal Yan swiftly positioned himself in front of Yu Hao, a clear sign that danger was imminent. Principal Yan referred to the assailant as Zhang Peng, an old friend, which piqued Principal Yang's curiosity about Zhang Peng's survival. Principal Yan wasted no time in questioning Zhang Peng about whether he intended to defeat him on that fateful day. In response, Zhang Peng cheekily remarked that Principal Yan's foul-mouthed nature hadn't changed a bit. He confidently declared that Principal Yan would soon witness who would emerge victorious. Zhang Peng then boldly challenged Principal Yan to make a move. Sensing the urgency, Principal Xian intervened and instructed Principal Yan to protect Yu Hao while she dealt with Zhang Peng herself. Curiosity gets the better of him, and Yu Hao can't help but ask if Principal Xian's spirit essence is the embodiment of her true body. Without hesitation, Principal Xian activated her true body possession, much to Zhang Peng's amusement. He taunted Principal Xian, questioning why she was still by Principal Yan's side, and why they hadn't gone their separate ways. Principal Xian swiftly silenced him, commanding him to cease his chatter, and launched an attack. The confrontation between Zhang Peng and Principal Xian escalated into a fierce exchange. Zhang Peng chuckled and questioned if Principal Xian was the best opponent he could offer. Principal Xian appeared bewildered as Zhang Peng continued to taunt him, mockingly referring to him as Valkyrie. A surge of immense power emanated from Zhang Peng as he laughed. Principal Xian confronted Zhang Peng, questioning his audacity to appear in the mortal realm after being spared by Mulao in the past. Zhang Peng acknowledged the favor and mercy shown by Mulao, emphasizing that he had remained hidden from the world while Mulao was alive. However, with Mulao's passing, Zhang Peng felt liberated to reveal himself once again. Despite their acquaintance, Zhang Peng made it clear that Principal Xian and Yan were free to leave, but insisted that Yu Hao must stay. Principal Xian stood resolute against Zhang Peng's assault, displaying no fear and refusing to yield. With a sarcastic laugh, Zhang Peng unleashed a powerful attack, engulfing the surroundings in immense destructive force. Yu Hao couldn't help but ponder if this was truly what battles between Super Duluos entailed, a display of intense warfare and widespread devastation. Principal Yan urged Yu Hao to closely observe the battle, emphasizing that these high-level battles were rare opportunities for him to learn and gain valuable insights. Yu Hao eagerly agreed and directed his full attention towards the fight. Yan mentioned that Zhang Peng, the Scorpio Tiger Duluo, was notorious for his sinister tactics, such as consuming animal blood to sustain and enhance himself. Despite his wicked nature, their teacher had allowed him to continue due to the lesser presence of an evil aura at that time. Curious, Yu Hao asked Principal Yan if Principal Xian was utilizing her true body spirit essence in combat, as it seemed more like a dragon behind her rather than her own body. Principal Yan proceeded to explain to Yu Hao that true body possession was another technique for manifesting one's spirit essence through the body. He further elaborated that spirit masters could maintain their human form while employing this technique, but it required extensive mental strength training.
Do you want to know the name of this manga, along with all the manga names of the recaps we did in our channel? How about also the chapter numbers our recaps end? You can simply ask the names in our Discord community for free or become a donor to get them all in one place. You can either be a donor in Patreon or be a member in our YouTube channel. Just scan this QR code or go to the link in the description to become a donor. Moreover, becoming a donor automatically makes you a VIP member of our Discord server with over tens of thousands of members.
Principal Yan also mentioned that while true body possession was ideal for spirit masters skilled in close combat, it also placed significant strain on the body. Contemplating its potential applications in his combat style, Yu Hao considered the possibility that this method might be suitable for him in the future. Yu Hao couldn't help but marvel at the relentless and powerful attacks of Principal Xian. It seemed like the Scorpio Tiger Duluo was on the verge of collapsing under the pressure. However, Principal Yan had a different perspective. He believed that Zhang Peng still had more to offer and that his true abilities were yet to be unleashed. As Principal Xian continued to fight fiercely, urging Zhang Peng to retreat, Yu Hao watched in awe as the Scorpio Tiger Duluo eventually succumbed to defeat. However, Principal Yan had a surprising revelation for Yuhao that was just the spirit essence and true body of the Scorpio Tiger Duluo. Zhang Peng then revealed his trump card, transforming into the Dark Demon Spirit Tiger. Principal Xian was left perplexed by this unexpected turn of events. Principal Yan explained that this was Zhang Peng's unique skill, the Dark Demon Spirit Tiger, which allowed him to unleash the Soul Beast Spirit he had absorbed. The Spirit Tiger exuded a fierce aura, its red eyes piercing through the battlefield as Principal Xian desperately tried to mount a counterattack. Yu Hao noticed that Principal Xian harnessed the power of the departed souls to launch his retaliation. Contemplating his upcoming confrontation with Zhang Peng, Yu Hao felt unsure. Principal Yan comforted Yu Hao, assuring him that even Zhang Peng wouldn't dare to challenge both him and Principal Xian single-handedly. He then permitted Yu Hao to unveil himself. Suddenly, a man materialized in front of Principal Yan and Yu Hao, acknowledging that after years of isolation, most of his former companions had probably already passed on. Yu Hao observed the man's impressive cultivation level, feeling the heavy atmosphere around them. The man regretted not visiting Mu En before his passing, mourning the loss and his indecision. Now, with Mu En gone, he started to question his past choices. Principal Yan sensed a dangerous aura coming from the man. Introducing himself as Long Xiao Yao, he asked if Principal Yan remembered him. Principal Yan was shocked, recognizing him as the Dragon Emperor of Duluo. He was surprised by Long Xiao Yao's continued existence. Yu Hao could sense genuine sorrow from Long Xiao Yao. Principal Yan showed respect, acknowledging Long Xiao Yao as one of the Black Holy Dragons in the Black and White Holy Dragon duo, along with his teacher. He was amazed to meet Long Xiao Yao in person. Long Xiao Yao explained that he came to see Yu Hao, a student highly regarded by Yan, to test his strength. However, out of respect for Mu En, he decided to spare Yan's life. Still, Long Xiao Yao insisted that Principal Yan could not leave. Principal Yan interrogated Senior Long regarding his motive to launch an assault against them. Senior Long explained that he was executing the orders of another person as he owed them a considerable debt. In an attempt to negotiate, he proposed a proposition. If they could endure 3 consecutive attacks from him, Principal Yan would surrender the ring, granting them the freedom to depart. Despite Principal Yan's desperate pleas, Senior Long remained resolute in his determination to proceed with his scheme. As Senior Long unleashed his assault, the sheer force of his power destroyed to unfold all around them. Amidst the chaos, Principal Yang stood unwavering, reminding Senior Long that although he could take on his name, he could never replicate his level of cultivation. Principal Yang emphasized that the person Senior Long was impersonating must possess a power that could rival their esteemed teachers. A mischievous chuckle escaped Senior Long's lips as he defied Principal Yang's words, mentioning that there were still 2 more strikes to come. However, Yu Hao couldn't help but question the motive behind targeting them, considering their young age. He boldly asserted that Senior Long had no authority to invoke his teacher's name, claim friendship, or demand 3 attacks. Yu Hao firmly declared that unless Senior Long succeeded in killing him, he would never surrender the ring. Principal Yan, in a cautious tone, warned Yu Hao about the consequences of his audacious words, revealing that Senior Long was none other than the legendary Dragon Emperor Duluo. Senior Long questioned Yu Hao's loyalty as Mu En's disciple, to which Yu Hao proudly confirmed. He boldly confronted Senior Long, insinuating that he only refrained from attacking them out of fear of tarnishing his reputation as Mu En's former master. Yu Hao saw through Senior Long's arrogance, believing he spared them to save face. Senior Long, intrigued by Yu Hao's boldness, asked if he was accusing him of bullying. He then proposed a challenge, a battle where Yu Hao would win if he could make him retreat half a step using equal spirit power. Principal Yan approved Yu Hao's challenge against Senior Long. Yu Hao proposed a wager. If he could end a battle between Principal Xian and Zhang Peng within a minute, Senior Long would have to concede defeat. Senior Long found the proposal interesting and accepted the unusual challenge. When asked about his confidence in winning, Yu Hao assured Principal Yan of his victory and emphasized the speed with which he would achieve it. As Zhang Feng and Principal Xian clashed in a fierce battle, Yu Hao stood on the sidelines, his mind racing with thoughts on how to bring this confrontation to a swift conclusion. Gathering his courage, Yu Hao tapped into the wisdom of his teacher, channeling an immense energy that transformed the air around them. Principal Xian, taken aback by this unexpected shift, couldn't help but question the sudden transformation. Undeterred, Yu Hao unleashed his attack with unwavering determination. As Zhang Peng pondered over the sudden surge of power, Principal Xian resorted to manipulating Zhang Peng's abilities in an attempt to counter him. Perplexed, Zhang Peng questioned her motives. In the meantime, Yu Hao enlightened him by revealing that it was the power of illumination. Senior Long, captivated by the phenomenon, remarked that this surge of power was anything but ordinary, suggesting that it could even instill fear in spirits. He then turned to Yu Hao and inquired about the name of the force he had just harnessed. Unable to hide the true nature of his power, Yu Hao disclosed to Long Xiaoyao that it was the power of purification, amplified by Electrolux's ability to intensify the potent rays of the sun. While this power didn't cause harm to regular spirit masters, it had a profound impact on malevolent spirit masters, completely subduing them. Accepting defeat, Long Xiaoyao admitted his loss and kept his promise to spare their lives. He expressed a heightened curiosity about Yu Hao, indicating a strong desire to delve deeper into his story. Principal Yan voiced his apprehension regarding the fairness of the match, highlighting the significant power gap between Long Xiaoyao and Yu Hao. However, Principal Yan urged everyone to have faith in Yu Hao's decision-making, emphasizing that his actions were not impulsive but carefully thought out. He referred to a previous incident where Yu Hao assisted Principal Xian in defeating the formidable scorpion tiger Duluo, underscoring Yu Hao's ability to strategize and triumph against formidable adversaries. Principal Xian expressed his concern, stressing the utmost importance of safeguarding Yu Hao at any cost. Principal Yan echoed this sentiment, declaring his willingness to lay down his life to ensure Yu Hao's safety, as it was a responsibility entrusted to him by their teacher. Meanwhile, Long Xiaoyao observed Yu Hao's extraordinary mental and spiritual prowess, acknowledging Mu Lao's exceptional talent in nurturing exceptional disciples. Senior Long was taken aback by the radiance in Yu Hao's eyes, sensing an unsettling aura emanating from him. Despite Yu Hao's young age, his gaze exuded a commanding presence that even Senior Long found intimidating.